Today is a very special day. Since COVID-19, I have not been able to witness the glory of cinema in its truest form. Here now, the sun of cinema has dawned upon the world, and films are releasing worldwide once again. Today, I made my return to a theater after 2 years.
On the occasion of my birthday, I went out with my friend Jayesh
to watch the much-awaited film Gangubai Kathiawadi, directed by Sanjay Leela Bhansali. I have watched most of Sanjay's post-2000 filmography in theaters. If you truly want to enjoy the scale and beauty of his works, you must watch his films on the big screen. Well known for indulging his audiences on large decorative set pieces, dances, music, and dramatic storytelling, Sanjay is an auteur whose vision illuminates before us, providing us an eye feast, but also touching our hearts.
Okay, here we go.
M1314.
This just brings back so many memories.
The very moment the projector lighted up, I got emotional. It was like reuniting with a long-lost friend or revisiting a place I knew was home. In the very first frame, I started crying as I witnessed a young girl being forced to wear makeup to please her customers. The girl is adamant, and Gangubai is called upon to persuade her. The grand entrance of Alia Bhat, completely in character as Gangubai Kathiawadi, got the audience whistling and cheering. Under all the good noise, I could hear my heart beat fast, as the communal experience with total strangers was a human experience I had long wished to be a part of. Gangubai would free the young girl and send her home, setting the tone for the film. Gangubai is a mafia queen, with a golden teeth and a heart of gold. Gangubai tells her story to the young girl. The flashbacks provide us a glimpse into the early life of Gangubai when she was called Ganga. Young Ganga, who wants to be a heroine. Ganga is sold by one of her family members, betrayed by her boyfriend, and sold to a brothel in Kamathipura. She is scared, helpless. Her innocence is haunting, and haunted by the darkness that the colorful area possesses. In Kamathipura, she meets Sheila. Sheila is played by the great Seema Pama, who plays this manipulative businesswoman, a dominating figure. Here, giving a glass of water holds a symbolic meaning. Giving water is like giving life or a chance to live. Young Ganga, when she enters Kamathipura, is given a glass of water by Sheila, which she refuses, knowing that the life Sheila is pushing her into is that of misery. Years later, Gangubai is giving a glass of water to the young girl I mentioned off earlier. The difference being that this time, the person giving the glass of water is not manipulative, but genuinely caring. In the few scenes that Vijay Raz as Raziabai appears, he steals the limelight with his subtle greatness. Ajay Devgan, who plays Mafia Don Lala, is so charming in his role that every time he enters the frame, you stare in awe. When Shantanu Maheshwari as Ramnik Lal comes to her life, Gangubai regains the innocence of the young Ganga. She can be her childhood self in front of him, but she demands respect and honor. Just through the lovely songs in the movie like Jab Sanya and Meri Jaan, their relationship is highlighted. Their individual insecurities are visible and their needs are understood. She remarks, and I am paraphrasing, "Many people come here, but you are the first man to do so." Owing to his good-natured self and pleasant attitude, she changes the meaning of masculinity from being toxic to being kind. She herself becomes the symbol of femininity. She remarks, "When the goddess of strength, that is Durga, the goddess of wisdom, that is Saraswati, and the goddess of wealth, that is Lakshmi, are all women, then why do men possess such vanity?" Jim makes his return to a Sanjay Leela Bhansali film as Fazi the Journalist. Also, if you have not watched Sanjay's Padmavat, just watch it for Jim's brilliant performance. It's one of the best supporting character acting of the decade. In Gangubai, Jim as Fazi acts as Gangubai's messenger to the entire country as he writes about her in the Urdu Times, She demands the rights of the women and girls at Kamathipura. She fights to provide education for the young girls, going all the way to the Prime Minister's office to make her voice heard. She lives in the walls of Kamathipura and in the hearts of those who love her. The movie ends saying, Gangubai came to be a heroine, but went away becoming a film. A meta line that kept ringing in my ears the whole day. The movie is not gritty, nor melodramatic. It is a fictionalized story that needs to be heard by men and women who turn a blind eye and become indifferent to injustice and yet choose to act as though they are morally righteous. The film is a commentary on feminism, and the film will be studied for generations as a lesson on cruelty of the harsh world and how one woman turned into a fierce fighter, not just for herself, but for her community as a whole. The film awakens emotions in you till the very end. I was teary-eyed almost throughout the film.
So how was it?
The heart and soul of the movie is of course Alia Bhat's performance and Sanjay Leela Bhansali's direction. They bring a powerful script to life to a great extent. There were times when people were cheering both in the movie and in the audience I was a part of, and I could not differentiate which was which. That right there is the magic of cinema.